Everybody say showers of blessing. It's coming upon me. It will come upon my family. Why don't you rise up? Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. We need mercy drops round us are falling. Both for the showers we everybody sing aloud. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. We need mercy drops round us are falling. Both for the showers we there shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of love. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior above. Showers of blessing, showers of blessing. We need mercy drops round us are falling. But for the showers we bleed, there shall be showers of blessing. Precious reviving again over the hills and the valleys. Sound of abundance of rain. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling. But for the showers we plead, there shall be showers of blessing. Send them upon us, O Lord. Grant us now a refresh. Come and now honor thy word. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. We need mercy drops round us are falling. But for the showers we plead, there shall be showers of blessing. Oh, that here they might fall. Now as to God we're confessing, now as on Jesus we call. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. We need
mercy drops round us are falling. But for the showers we plead,
there shall be showers of blessing. If we but trust and obey, there shall be seasons refreshing. If we let God have his way, showers of blessing. Showers of blessing we need. Mercy drops round us are falling. showers with me. Amen. The showers will get to you in Jesus' name. You can be seated now. In Mark chapter 6, I'm reading from verses 30 and 31. Mark chapter 6, verse 30. And the apostles gathered themselves together unto Jesus and told him all things, both what they had done and what they had taught. And he said unto them, come ye yourselves apart into a desert place and rest a while. For there were many coming and going, and they had no leisure so much as to eat. Here we see the Lord Jesus Christ calling his own people apart. And the Lord has not changed what he did for his people before. He still did for his people and to his people today. The Lord knows how busy we are. He knew how busy they were. They have been busy in the work of the Lord. They were doing a very good thing. But they became so busy that they didn't have time to minister to their own needs as well. Their physical needs, their natural needs, and their spiritual needs. So he said, after they had told him all that he did and all that he taught, he said, come ye yourselves apart. And that's what the Lord himself had always done, even for himself. We're told that after a busy day, the Lord himself will set himself apart. And he will go and fellowship with the Heavenly Father. He will receive more anointing, unction, inspiration, wisdom, vision, passion, fire. He'll receive again from the Lord. And then he wanted his own disciples to do the same. Because they had not had enough time for themselves. The same thing we say about ourselves. In fact, the same thing the Lord himself is saying about you and about me. That there are times we need to come together. And this is what is called retreat. If you understand the use of that language, advance, that means you are moving on, you are moving forward. And then you are waging war against the enemy. You are advancing. You are active and you are full of action. You are sweating, you are working, you are laboring. And now, after some time, you retreat. You come back. You withdraw yourself. Why? Because you need to revitalize yourself, recuperate. You need to increase your energy, recover your energy. And you need to come back to the Lord so that you'll be able to refresh yourself, renew your strength, and you'll be able to receive from heaven. That's why we have retreat. And this December retreat will be a moment of unforgettable encounter in Jesus' name. This year's December retreat, which is fast approaching now. And likewise, the danger of our approaching it in a very casual, routine manner. You see, there are some people, they cheat themselves, and they lose a lot. They do not know that this is a very special moment for you and for me, and for everyone, for your family, for your children, for your wife, for your husband, for your neighbors, and for the people around you. And they come casually. Yes, they still come. But they come in a very casual way, in a very casual manner. And they do not have at the back of their mind, here is a special time. Here is a wonderful time, and I need to go to the Lord at this special time with a special attitude and a special expectation, and special miracle will be mine. The Lord has abundance of blessings enough to meet the needs of all his children. But listen to this, you even need to write this now. Expectation determines realization. Expectation determines realization. You see what you're expecting. All that you want the Lord to do for you. Yes, there's going to be a wonderful covenant month in January. But even then, at the end of the year, this December, we're coming together. And all that we're envisioning, all we're desiring, all that we're expecting, we're putting everything down. And we're saying, as the year closes, as this December comes, and then I go to this place in the presence of the Lord Almighty himself. And then I move on into the new year. I'm having great expectation because I know this, that my expectation determines my realization. You've heard of the law of sowing and reaping. It applies here too. If we sow real faith, if we sow great expectations, if we sow serious publicity, if we sow earnest prayers, and if we sow full participation into this coming retreat, we're sure to reap, and you will reap in Jesus' name. Reaping abundant, bountiful blessings from the Lord, and reaping divine revelations. Revelations the Lord will show you about yourself, about your future, about your family, about your aspirations, about your ambition, about everything you need, everything you want. And then the Lord will also give you and your worry great miracles. All impossibilities will become possible. In fact, the Lord is taking you to this mount of transfiguration. And in your location where you are, for those of us who are outside Lagos. And in Lagos here, we were using our Deeperlife Campus Conference Center, you know, whatever you want to call it now. I almost call it campus. What is it, campus? What is it? It's a center. What is it? It's a mount of transfiguration. If you've not been there, visit that place and see the change that has taken place in that place. You almost will not believe your eyes. If you've been there some, you know, few months ago and say, what kind of place is this? Where am I going to sleep? Where am I going to lie down? Where am I going to sit down? You get there. This December, the Lord will surprise you. In fact, as you are stepping in like this, blessings, you just be looking up, it's like rain is falling on me. And it's a rain of blessing. And it's a rain of miracle. And it's a rain, all that rain that will fall upon you, the rain will wash away every calamity from your life in Jesus' name. It will follow you. It will follow your children. It will fall on your family. That place, I'm telling you, is a place dedicated for blessing. Your blessing is there. You must receive your blessing in Jesus' name. That's why the Lord told his own disciples, he said, come ye apart, because they had not had any time to minister to themselves, their own physical needs, their own spiritual needs, their own social needs. They have been ministering to other people. It was time now for other people to serve them, and for the Lord himself to serve them and minister unto them. That's why the Lord is inviting you at this time, and you will be there. In Revelation chapter 22, I'm reading from verse 17. Here it tells us, it says, and the Spirit and the Bride say, come. Everyone has to see the poster. Everyone has to see the banners. Everyone has to see the handbill. The Spirit of the Lord himself is saying, I have a special work to do within you. I have a special work to do in you. I have a special work to do for you. I have a special thing to do through you. And I'll meet you in that place, in a place of blessing, where the Lord is going to bless you. And the Lord is going to shower his blessing upon you. That's why the Spirit of the Lord is pleading with you and is saying, come. And the Bride of the Lamb, the people of God, the children of God, the members of the living God, of the church of the living God, they are also beckoning to you and they are saying, have you heard? Something great is taking place. Have you heard? Something wonderful is taking place. Have you heard? A special thing that we never knew, we never saw it like this before, is coming your way. That's why the whole membership of the church of the living God, anywhere you are, that's why they are calling and they are saying, come. And let him that heareth say, come. As you hear, pass it on. As you hear about it, pass it on. Everyone that hears, you hear it in your house fellowship. You hear it in the youth group. You hear it in your school. You hear it on your campus. Or you hear it on your street. Everyone that heareth, let him say, come. Get your neighbors to come. Get the people to come. I can tell you this. For everyone that you invite, everyone that you bring, the blessing the Lord is giving them, because you are the one that brought them, he will share part of that blessing with you. you will receive your own blessing normally, 100%. Nothing will be taken away from your blessing. Then for every other person, you say, I'm assisting the Spirit of God. I'm agreeing with the Spirit of God. I am cooperating with the Spirit of God. And I'm telling other people, I'm telling my neighbors, I'm telling my classmates, I'm telling people around me, come. Every blessing they receive, the Lord will also add to your own blessing, a part of the blessing they receive in Jesus' name. Let him that is a thirst come. Aren't you thirsty for something? Aren't you desirous of something? Aren't you expecting something? Aren't you passionate for something? Aren't you saying, are you not saying, there's something I've been asking for? I'm thirsty, I'm hungry, I'm desirous, I'm passionate about it, I'm looking for something. Then come, because it says, let everyone that is athirst come, and whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely. Everything you get there will be free in Jesus' name. What you cannot buy with money. If you are barren, you have children. If you have not married yet, well, in fact, how can I tell you? How can I reveal this to you? Every morning, early in the morning, I'm going to start you with faith clinic. And in that faith clinic, every weakness you bring there, every need you bring there, everything will be totally taken care of in Jesus' name. Then your home. I'm giving some time to your home as well. In fact, it's going to be wonderful at this time. As the Lord has been revealing himself as to what is coming in this December retreat, it's like even in my own mind, as I'm looking ahead, it's like God is shortening the days. I want to be in a hurry. I want to get to that December retreat because it's going to be a wonderful time. And what if I know you'll be there at the end of the retreat? You said, they said so, the pastor said so. See my blessing, because your cup will be overflowing. Your cup will be overflowing because it's going to be a moment of unforgettable encounter with the Lord. You're welcome.